There are currently several mutations found on the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2 that are circulating around the world. Now, these mutations are arising because more and more people are beginning to get infected. And the SARS-CoV-2 virus can only replicate within our cells, which allows it to have these potential mutations. Now, you can think of these mutations as if you were going to write the same sentence over and over and over again. Now, if you kept writing them, you might make a small mistake, but the sentence could still make sense. But if you make too many mistakes, that sentence might not make sense anymore, and it might have a different meaning. Now, when the SARS-CoV-2 virus continues replicating inside of us, it could make these same mistakes, and if there's too many changes that occur on that spike protein, it could change the shape and then potentially the function. So to give an update on the current mutations that we know of the spike protein, in the UK variant of the asparagine at position 501 that has now been changed to tyrosine, studies show that the mRNA vaccines that elicit the antibodies that we need to neutralize this virus show around a similar to a threefold decrease in their binding affinity. This means that the variants are still able to be destroyed by these mRNA vaccines targeting SARS-CoV-2. But if we look at the South Africa variant, where glutamic acid at position 484 has now been changed to lysine, these studies also are showing around a 6- to 10-fold lower binding affinity of the antibodies to this variant, meaning the vaccines are still working to destroy this virus, just not as efficiently as the non-mutated form. So you may need more antibodies in order to destroy this mutated form of the virus. But in the future, companies such as Moderna are designing new mRNAs that take into account these and other potential mutations that are occurring to have a potential third dose that could offer us these additional antibodies to fight off these mutants. But the best thing you can do to avoid these mutations is to continue following the current guidelines in your area to help keep yourself safe and those around you healthy.